It was Linda, I think, who suddenly thought, well, you know, if we're going to have a bunch of people, instead of just having some models in there, wouldn't it be great if each one of them was like a face you'd recognise? And they go, oh, it's him, you know. So we just literally got their phone numbers. Hello, Mr. Coburn. I've got this record, and there's this sort of cover, and it's a band on the run, and what do you say? And he's quite a swinger, James, you know. Oh, sure, yeah, you know, he was into it, well into it. I just liked James Coburn, you know, I just like his stuff. I liked him from The Magnificent Seven, I think.
I was in town, and I guess it was Linda that called me. She asked me if I was busy on whatever day, it was a Sunday or something. And I said, no, why, what's happening? Well, we're doing this little, that told me what it was. And we're all gathering at the Italian restaurant, and then we'll go out and take some pictures. There'll be some people there that I'm sure you'll know, blah, blah, blah. And I said, I thought, no, Paul McCartney, why did they want me on this, on the cover of this thing? And so I said, sure, why not? I'd love to. And so I did. I remember that rainy day, though. We had bit lunch in some Italian restaurant. Everybody gathered there and was, you know, jiving away, you know. And it was raining, you know. And the photographer kept taking picture after picture after picture. All the guys were great, though. We had a good time. I just thought it would be a kick. I mean, because I'd never met Paul. I'd never met Linda. And so I thought, yeah, well, you know, like, here's a couple of people that I'd like to meet. With Paul than almost any of the guys, because he continues to evolve.
John Conte was a Liverpool lad who I'd been going to a lot of his boxing matches and seen him win the light heavyweight championship, so I was right behind John. Linda and I used to go to the fights. I used to think it was like the ultimate in theatre.
The best one I like about that was their Band on the Run. I think it's the slowness of it at the beginning. And it seems to reach like a climax, an escape, an explosion. Band on the run, and we head into the sun. And the first one said to the second one, I hope you're having fun. So there seems to be some kind of messages then, you know. One's passing the message, they've got an experience, and they pass a message on to someone else, like, you know. So you've got all these people on the run, you know, and the run maybe being of, you know, life itself, locked in this prison of, self or whatever it is, or problem, whatever your problem, or an actual prison as well, you know. But what's funny about that album is that I had these fancy shoes. I just bought them, like two-tone shoes. And on the cover, it's on the cover now, I always looked that I didn't have any shoes, rough shoes to wear, or the shoes what would be suitable for a prisoner to be wearing. And I've got these like really fancy two-tone shoes on, and they're still on the cover, I always remember that. I look at it and obviously people say, well, he's not a proper prisoner, you know what I mean? Because he's got these fancy shoes, or if he is a proper prisoner, I'd like to go to that prison, you know? These are better than freedom shoes. These freedom shoes are killing me. I want those prison shoes. What are you going on?